drink with me. Drink with me, drink with me. Drink with me, drink with me.
See me up in the club with 50 loving girls. Posted in the back, down my fangs in my grill. Brooklyn brim with my eyes sitting low. Never born here.
Hey guys, and welcome back. So for today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I created this bold blue eyeshadow look. I'm so excited about this video because literally it's an easy eye look. I only apply like one or two shades on my lid and all of the attention is going to be on the lower lash line. I wanted to go ahead and top it off with this bold dramatic blue lip. I didn't think that I would ever wear this color, honestly, but once I finished my eye look, I was like, you know what? I might as well just go ahead and top it off with this bold blue lipstick. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be wearing it like all night, but I definitely think for this video, it suits the purpose. So if you guys have not subscribed to my channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. And if you guys want to see how I created this bold blue eyeshadow look, then please keep watching. So first, I'm going to be setting my eyelids with the Ben Nye Banana Powder. So for my transition color, I'm going to be going into the Sephora Color Anthology palette, and I'm going to pick up this taupe shade right here, and I think this is probably the only color I'm going to put on my lid. I always like to use a transition color that's my complexion, or maybe a little bit darker. I'm going to be picking up this shade right here, and also just applying that on top of the transition color. Okay, so next I'm going to be picking up this cobalt blue shade right here. I'm just going to be applying that all over my lash line. And to apply that, I'm going to be using a Morphe E36. And be careful not to get it in your eye because... So I'm also going to be picking up this dark blue shade right here. It has a little bit of a shimmer to it. And I'm just going to go in and apply that right below where I applied that cobalt blue. And I'm using a Morphe Y21. So next I'm going to be picking up this Ulta eyeliner, and this is in the shade Matte Navy. I think it's like the perfect blue eyeliner to complete this look. So I'm just going to apply that on my waterline if my mirror will stay in place. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do a wing liner just to add a little more drama to my upper eyelid. And I'm going to be going in with the NYX. This is the Black Noir. It's the Vinyl Liquid Liner. I just have to get used to the flimsy tip because it doesn't like just go straight. I have to like kind of force it. But I think we're good. Just want a little baby wing. Now I'm just gonna coat my lashes with the Colossal by Maybelline Spider Effect Mascara. So I'm going to be going in with these lashes that I picked up on Amazon, and I believe they're called the yegz lashes. They're just super flary and I like them. They're kind of like, I guess, faux mink. So So I'm just going to apply some more mascara just to kind of make them look a little bit more blended. Not that I need it, but I feel like I just want them to be a little more dramatic, honestly. So now I'm just going to wipe off all of this excess setting powder and finish my face. I'm actually waiting until my mascara dries to wipe this part off, but I'm going to wipe off all of this. Nice and sharp, baby. I'm going to go ahead and set my contour. And I'm going to be using the Anastasia Contour Kit. And I'm going to be going in with the Morphe Y4 brush. Now I'm just going to be sweeping away the setting powder underneath my eyes very carefully. Now I'm going to be going into my Becca times Jaclyn Hill face palette. Hopefully you can see that. And I'm going to be picking up, I'm going to mix actually this shade right here. It's like a little brown shade, but it has like a pinkish undertone, I've noticed. And I'm going to mix some of this mineralized blush right there. I'm just going to apply that to the apples of my cheeks. And I'm also going to be picking up Champagne Pop and Prosecco Pop. I'm going to mix both of those together. And I'm just going to apply those at the high points of my cheek. And I'm also going to be highlighting the bridge of my nose. That I've highlighted my entire face, I'm going to go in with the Gerard Slay All Day in the scent Lavender. And this is just going to melt all of those powders in and make everything look really cohesive. Now to lock in my foundation even more, I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay D-Slick Makeup Setting Spray. Now for lips, I'm going to be going in with two different colors, and I'm going to be using the L'Oreal Infallible Lip Paint. I'm going to go in with the color Domineering Till and also Topless, or Topless. I can never say that right. First, I'm going to go in with Topless since it's lighter and I don't want to mess up my brush. And then I'm going to go in with Domineering Till. It wasn't as subtle as I thought. We're gonna rock it. I'm gonna go and finish my hair and finish my outfit, and then I'll be back and we'll see if I kept it or if I left it. So guys, this is the completed look, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up before you head out the door. And until my next video, I'll see you guys very soon. Bye.